Click subscribe and bell icon to get regular notifications.
Good morning. I'm Dr. Kirti Talari. I'm a rheumatologist at Yashoda Hospital, Secunderabad. Today we are going to talk about a disease called SLE or systemic lupus erythematosus, or simply called lupus. Lupus is basically an autoimmune disease. When we say autoimmune disease, it means that our immunity is attacking our own body. Normally, immunity is our resistance power. It's our power to fight against any infections that are affecting our own body. And it is usually protective for one's body. But certain times this immunity can attack their own self, and that is when we call it autoimmunity. Lupus is one of the most important autoimmune diseases, which commonly affects women between 15 to 40 years of age. So very young women can get affected with this disease. Males are rarely affected in this particular condition, but no age is an exception. There could be sometimes very young children who can get the disease. There could be elderly people also who may develop this disease. As I said, since this is an autoimmune disease, it can affect different parts of the body. Most of the times, 90% of the time, the disease affects your skin, joints, or the blood counts. So most of them present to us with skin rashes, especially over the cheeks and the nasal bridge on exposure to sun, but rashes can occur on any part of the body. Along with that, heavy hair loss, ulcers in the mouth, ulcers in the nose is another common symptom. Another set of people can start off with joint pains and joint swelling, with a lot of stiffness in the early morning when they'll not be able to make a fist. And certain people may present with decrease in blood counts, which can start off all of a sudden and does not respond to the common medications like iron tablets or vitamin supplements. So here what happens is the hemoglobin may just drop, the WBC count, platelet count may just drop, and despite giving them blood transfusions or platelet transfusions, the counts may not actually improve, because though we are supplying them from outside blood and blood products, the immunity within will keep damaging their blood cells. So this is the most common presentation, but along with this, a lot of other people can present with kidney problems. Like 50% of them can have protein loss through their kidney. It does not mean that the kidney is damaged. It just means that kidney is losing more protein. And if we diagnose it at an early stage that they have a kidney problem, it is possible to completely control this problem and get the kidney back to complete normal stage. 30% of them can have problems in the muscles, can have problem with their heart or the lungs. So they can present with chest pain, breathlessness, that is they have shortness of breath intermittently or on walking. They can have chest pain to one side of the chest, or they can have a central chest pain. And they could have problems with their intestines, they can have problems with their nerves or the brain. So basically, lupus does not spare any organ. It can affect any organ, and for the first time you may actually present with any different symptom. So most of the times patients with lupus do not reach a rheumatologist initially. They have symptoms pertaining to any particular organ. For example, they may initially have only a skin rash, then they may meet a dermatologist. Or if they have, suppose say, a chest pain, or if they're having breathlessness, they may actually meet a cardiologist. And it is basically this particular specialty or this particular physician who may actually see you, keep your symptoms all together and look at your reports, and then may diagnose that you probably may have lupus, and that is when you're referred to a rheumatologist. The role of a rheumatologist in lupus is that first they'll confirm that this is lupus by asking your symptoms, by looking at your blood investigations and doing certain tests that are very, very specific for lupus, that is called ANA. So based on this, we make a diagnosis of lupus, and after we make a diagnosis of lupus, we look at which organs are actually getting affected, because you may have only joint pains, but you may actually have an internal organ involvement like a kidney involvement, which may not be obvious to you, but may be obvious on the test that we do. So we do some tests to find out which other organ is involved, and after we find out which organs are involved in lupus, accordingly the treatment would change. In lupus, we will have to give steroids in the initial phases at higher doses. Normally for a common man, steroids are not good for the health, because they actually decrease their immunity. But in lupus, immunity is affecting their own body. It is immunity which is at fault. So we have to control this immunity, and that is why steroids become very, very important in the initial phases of treatment of lupus. In the long term, we do not want to continue very high doses of steroid. We would actually put steroids at very, very low doses, which do not cause any harm to you. So basically, we'll be maintaining a very low dose of steroid. But since we do not want the disease to increase as we are decreasing the steroid, we add on something called steroid sparing agents, which have the same effects as that of steroids, but they do not have the major side effects that steroids usually have. So these steroid sparing agents are very helpful in lupus in controlling the disease for long term and also in improving the survival of a patient. Usually, people who have lupus can have a mild disease where they may have only a skin or a joint involvement or a minimal decrease in their blood counts, or they may even have a severe disease where the kidneys or nerves are getting affected. Now, depending on the severity of the disease, the treatment for an individual person can change. There could be people who are only given low doses of steroids, there could be people who are given very high doses of steroids, there could be people who are given steroid sparing agents or immunosuppressants which are mild or which are severe. Depending on the stage of the disease, the treatment can actually vary. For people who do not take treatment, what would actually happen is, initially the disease is in a treatable stage. If we start off treatment in the early stage of a kidney disease, then the kidney can come back to completely normal. But if we do not do that, in the long term, the kidney may actually get damaged. There could be an increase in creatinine. You may have to be put on dialysis, or you may have to go for a renal transplant also. Lupus is not a very small disease to have. There could be a lot of complications even in people who are very, very regular on treatment. There could be flares in particular situations, like whenever your dose has suddenly decreased, or you've stopped medications for a few days, or you're going through a very stressful situation, wherein the disease may suddenly increase and it may become very difficult at times to control the disease completely back to normal. It has been known that people who have lupus, at the end of 5 years, out of every 100 patients, only 90 of them would survive. A lot of research is going on in the subject to see that even these 10 people lead a normal life, but that's how the disease is at its stage at present. So basically what we expect from the patient's end is a regular follow-up with regular monitoring and treatment as advised, and keeping us regularly informed about any new symptom that they develop. So in the initial few years, we may actually ask you to come for a monthly or a 2-monthly follow-up. And once we find that the disease is completely under control, we have a control over the situation, then we would actually call you every 3 to 6 months to see that and accordingly modify the medications. Certain patients with lupus who are very well under control can actually be completely off most of the medications and may have to continue just 1 or 2 medications. The precautions that we expect from the patient's end, first thing is that UV rays have been found to increase lupus. They increase the production of ANA within the body and can worsen the disease per se. So what we usually expect for patients who have lupus is that they should not get exposed to sunlight between 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. And even if they have to get exposed due to some reasons, it is better that you'll use sunscreens, use hats or umbrellas to avoid direct exposure to sun. Second thing is practicing a very healthy lifestyle, that is 30 minutes of exercise per day, along with a good balanced diet, that is eating a lot of green leafy vegetables, fruits, taking a lot of milk and milk products, avoiding a lot of oily stuff and junk food or outside food is one thing that we expect. And another thing that we expect from patients is that you have to protect yourself from infections as much as possible. So hygiene, personal hygiene and hygiene at home is something that is very, very important. And avoiding overcrowded places where you can easily catch infections is one more thing that you should be doing, because as such your immunity is not functioning very well. And on top of that, we are giving immunosuppressants which can further decrease your immunity. So developing infections is something that is very commonly seen in patients with lupus. Another thing that a lot of people have a doubt about is that usually most of these lupus patients are very young. They are between this 15 to 30 years of age, an age where they get married, where they have to plan a family, where they may have they'll have to handle their kids after that. So a lot of parents and patients with lupus or their husbands keep asking whether they can actually lead a normal life, whether they can plan a pregnancy in the future, will the child have any problems. First thing is that if a patient has lupus and it is under complete control and a pregnancy is planned, they can have a completely normal baby with absolutely no problems. The outcomes of pregnancies in lupus are as much as that of a normal pregnancy only, but with the clause that your lupus should be completely under control. That is the most important thing. And lupus is not a disease that will spread to your baby post delivery, so that is one thing that you really need not be worried about. And definitely a patient with lupus when have to plan pregnancy whenever your rheumatologist says that your disease is completely under control. That is one thing. And during pregnancy also you may require more follow-ups, more regular monitoring compared to any other normal person. So considering that lupus is such a vast disease with so many manifestations, if you have lupus, you should be meeting a rheumatologist to find out which organs are affected, how severe is your lupus, and the treatment needs to be adjusted by them accordingly. For patients with lupus, we run a lupus clinic at Yashoda Hospital, Secunderabad, on every Wednesday in between 9 a.m. to 12 noon. So patients who have a suspicion or who have a doubt of having lupus or who have already been diagnosed with lupus and want to know more about their disease or want to know how severe is their disease and how their medications need to be adjusted or what medications need to be taken, who need counseling for both them and their family members, can visit this clinic, which is an exclusive lupus clinic on every Wednesday. Thank you.